and nobody told the king because he was away hunting. Soon, it was November 4th, and the plot was still in motion.
Not long now, so my wonderful plan will come to success. Captain for a game! Time is coming.
What are you doing on to the parliament?
Beloved son is dead, and I fear for the future of our monarchy. What shall we do? officially ending the American Revolution. 13 colonies had won their independence from England. A new country was born.
The new country was called the United States of America, but was not united. Each state had its own leaders and its own government. The states were like 13 separate countries.
We are not old now. Shouldn't someone be in charge?
We just got rid of King George. We don't want anyone telling us what to do.
I'll make my own decisions, thank you very much.
The country ran under a document called the Articles of Confederation. This political system gave the national government very little power. Each state took care of its own business.
But without a strong national government, the states had problems.
When they go to Rhode Island, they won't take my money.
Of course not. Money's worthless here.
And how can you do business with each other?
Don't we need a treaty to trade? Who can negotiate for all of us?
How can we decide once and for all who owns what?
New Hampshire is trying to claim land that belongs to me.
Not true! That land is mine!
Maybe it's time we sat down and talked about things.
In September 1786, delegates from Pennsylvania, Delaware, Virginia, New Jersey, and New York gathered in Annapolis, Maryland. They discussed the problems amongst the states and identified what had to be done.
The Articles of Confederation make the national government helpless and hopeless. We need a government that works.
But we only have 5 states represented here. What can we do?
We can call another convention. We can ask everyone to come and help revise the Articles of Confederation.
That's an excellent idea. Let's meet in Philadelphia in the same hall where the Declaration of Independence was signed.
You mean the room where it happened?
To the rescue.
I have an idea. The House of Representatives can be based on population. The 2 delegates for each state.
So no matter or how big or how small, each state will have 2 votes in the Senate.
But states with more people will have more delegates in the House of Representatives.
I can live with that.
I can too.
A major hurdle has been overcome. The delegates now are the framework for the new Constitution. But there were still many other decisions to be made.
How long should the each time they met with the president, he had another excuse.
Great war is near, and the world is looking out for our great democracy to
So year five, I just want to congratulate you. That was absolutely brilliant. I'm a history teacher, so I'm slightly biased. I remember studying lots of those topics when I was at school, and the only way we were able to show that we understood it was write an essay. So I think it was a much more enjoyable and really fantastic way, and you engaged with some really, I'm sure you're going to agree, really complicated, complex topics. I know they're currently working on Brexit. And I'm sure parents, when we talked about investing in technology last year, none of you realised it was a time machine. But congratulations, your creativity, the teamwork, remembering the lines, the acting, the singing was absolutely brilliant. Let's give them another. Actually, very fittingly, it is the home base for the acting profession in New York City, so we always love the fact that our young sort of aspiring actors have that opportunity to perform here. But thank you to the players. Thank you to our musicians for their brilliant thanks to Miss Fiona, Miss Scheiber, Mr. Hawkins, and Mr. Edwards for bringing this together. Lived with some of the songs and lived with rehearsing some of the lines.